in. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? It's Craft Farms here with another video, and today we are back on Dad's Farm, and super exciting moment, we have come to harvest. So we got the entire harvest crew out of the shed. The rest of the spring crew is all put away. I need to turn my game down to 20. I'm going to lag a lot here in the main yard, but nothing I can do but that. So we got the 4320 and the auger hook sitting here by the bins. Just going to wait until we have the first truckload of wheat. We got the Peterbilt 359 hooked to the Wilson hopper trailer. The T9 450 hooked to the 1300 Kinsey. The Lexion 770, and then obviously our 3500 hooked to the Roadrunner trailer with the grain platform on it. It seems like our grain platform is shifting for whatever reason. And as you can see, let's bring this up. All of the wheat is ready, so we're going to go ahead and get rolling. We will be dropping the straw for this. I don't want that. I want this guy. Because we're going to take the header up to the field. We're going to be starting on field one. So we're going to go ahead and take this guy up there. By the time you're seeing this video, you will have seen, hopefully, some real-life farming videos. I'm recording this on Wednesday. I'm going to be leaving in about an hour and a half or so. Or an hour, something like that. Figured I'd quick record a video since I'm up to harvest and I really want to start harvesting. Everything is planted. You can see our corn is coming up. Our wheat's ready here beside us. You can see our corn there on the left. And our beans are coming up pretty well as well. So we're looking at a pretty bountiful yield here this season. Hopefully we can max out our storage. Not sure how I'm going to do the storage thing. I'm probably just going to start filling and fill until, we'll see how good of a yield we have. And maybe I'll be like, okay, you know, these fields are going to have this on them and that kind of stuff or something like that. We'll find out. Let's get our beacons and hazards going on this guy and get him going to the field. So we'll see how good of a yield we're having and go from there. Maybe I'll have to be like, okay, these bins will be for wheat, these bins for soybeans, and these bins for corn. I hope that we end up having to haul stuff to the elevator, because that'll mean that we've had a super awesome harvest. So that would be awesome to have, but we'll find out, I guess, see what happens. So hopefully we don't have too low nutrients or too many weeds or anything. We'll see what happens, I guess, here. So we'll get the combine started, and then we'll take the truck to the field and get that positioned, and then we'll take the grain cart up. Or we can take the grain cart and the truck up at the same time, I guess. We can use Follow Me mod and get them to rolling up there and just check it out and see what our nutrients are going to be like. We'll just kind of walk around in the field a little bit, or else ride with the combine, and then once we get the truck and grain cart there, we can record the course play courses for the truck and grain cart. Or for the grain cart, I mean. The truck we will be running, and we'll also be running auger. And we'll be riding around in the combine and the grain cart as well. So you guys will get to see some of that too, not just the truck. Because we will have to... we'll have to do some sitting while we wait for the grain cart to fill and the combine stuff, so we'll be able to sit and ride around in the combine and the grain cart while we wait for the truck to be full. I'm not sure at this point if this is going to be your Saturday video or if it's going to be your Tuesday video. I'm just going to have to find out, I guess. You guys will know because you guys will see it, but for me, I don't know because today is only Wednesday, so I still have to get to the farm and stuff. So we need to load up field 1 combine grain. I made course play courses for fields 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then once we finish the wheat, then we'll go ahead and do... we want to enable the straw swath. Because we're going to drop this straw so that way we can bale it. And we will probably end up having to rent a baler. Just so that way our straw doesn't get consumed by soil mod. Because if it sits too long, then soil mod will just take it. So what we'll probably end up doing is renting the Heston baler and then hooking it to our 4320 and just running it like that. Since we don't have the money for buying a new tractor, we don't have the money for buying anything right now, but we can go ahead and rent some machines. So a baler is all that we're going to need. We don't need to go and rent a machine as well. We just need the baler. Alright, so we can turn off our hazards and all that junk. Get this guy hooked up. We need to unlock our load. We'll pull this guy forward. Spinning 2, 1. And I don't think that our header does need to be unfolded. Okay, so now turning around here is going to be a little bit tricky. We might run over just a little bit of wheat. I'm going to try and avoid that as much as I possibly can. So let's get this showing us all of our waypoints. That way I know where to start with the combine. Because I'm going to start the combine to cut our way into our first waypoint. There we go. Ah! Dang it. No, there we don't go. There we go. Now it's going. So yeah, we're running a pretty good yield, it looks like. Let's run up here and... snap a screenshot of this guy. Yeah, it is pretty early in the morning, but we had to... I didn't want to speed up time any farther because A, we'd go even more in debt, and B, we'd have to go through soil mod again, and don't want to do that. So we have until about 2 o'clock, I think, is when soil mod kicks in again. I think it's at 2 and midnight. Or something like that, or else noon and midnight, something like that, 1 and midnight. Soil mod kicks in a second time during the day, so we have to get all of this wheat combined before then. And wow, our combine is already half full, just about. So yeah, we're going to be running a good yield. Our grain cart's going to be very, very busy. So that's going to be good. I'm happy. I just want to double check that I'm recording. Yes, I am. Sometimes OBS likes to stop itself, or sometimes it just doesn't start. I have weird issues at times with it, so... actually, I really shouldn't have brought this pickup all the way back. I should have just moved it out of the way, because it would need... Well, actually, it can just sit right here. That's a good place for it. Alright, so we'll get the truck started up here and... We'll get up to here and then we'll hop in the grain cart. Yeah, wow. This guy's already almost full. That is amazing. So what we'll do when we get to the field is we'll run up and manually unload him. Just to... because we'll have to record course anyways, so we'll need the grain cart in anyway, so... Hopefully my frame rate will pick itself up because right now we're running a little too low. So we also need to create a folder titled Grain Cart. So I'll work on moving all that stuff later on. As you can see, I have 26-23, combine, grain cart, roller, sprayer, tedder, and that's all that we need at the moment. Or that should be all that we need in general, because selling we'll have to do manually because of the auger, which is okay. I don't mind doing that. It's definitely a lot of fun. Oh, and our New Holland came off of Follow Me. So we'll just get the truck up here, I guess, and go from there. We'll just bring the grain cart over. Which is alright, I guess. So we can go in cab now. Alright, so let's see. How do I want to line this guy up? Probably right up here. Right up along the road here. Right like that. So now we'll get the grain cart here. Turn on our beacons and hazards and stuff. And then we will carry on over to the field. So yeah, I'm super glad to be to this point. Normally when I play a map, I don't play it long enough to go all the way through a soil mod cycle, you know, like maintenance cycle, I mean, and get to harvest and then harvest, and normally I switch maps so often that I don't do that, but it's nice to be sticking down to a map for a while. We'll probably be on this map. Unless another really, really, really awesome map comes out, like if Clover Creek becomes public or something like that, one of those good maps. Unless that happens, we'll probably stick to Dad's farm here for quite a while, especially because we'll get into beef eventually as well. Now that I'm looking at it, we may not end up doing it after this season, because if we do, we'll have to take out quite a lot of a loan, so that way we don't go way into the red. During our maintenance cycle again, but we'll have to see. We'll see what happens. We may end up just taking out like maybe $1 million loan or something like that, on top of the $200,000 that the game allows you to take out standard. So let's, we got our tarp off now, so we'll head on up here to this and we'll turn off that. Head up here and unload our combine. Get all this stuff turned off so that way, we got a little close to the crop there and ran it over. So that way we can get a screenshot once we unload the combine. And actually, before we do, get this guy set to 6 miles per hour. Boy, this is gonna be a tight fit in here. Oh man, that's gonna suck. We're gonna have to manually do that every time. So, definitely not realistic to be going through the trees like this, but it can't be helped as we're on our first pass, so. Oh man, I'm getting close to him again. Trying to avoid the trees as much as I possibly can, because I don't want to end up hitting a tree. If I can help it. We're almost out of the trees, so. So hopefully course play will play nicely and allow the combine to unload automatically. Otherwise, we'll have to sit and unload that ourselves, which will suck. And that means every time that the combine fills up, we'll have to come over and press the period key, so that way it will unload. Let me get our auger put out here. Come around this corner like this, and then we'll start our course recording. We'll whip around like this, and then come up beside the truck. At a waypoint right there. So we'll finish unloading the grain cart here. And did it stop? Okay, it did. There we go. So now we'll go over here. And hit stop recording. We want to be, I don't know if it's combi. No, overloader. I know this thing's weird the way that's set up. Oh man. Don't tell me. Well, that sucks. We're going to have to run grain cart as well. That's just great. Alright, well, I guess we're going to be stuck in the grain cart now. Come on, cab light, turn on. Can't get the cab light to turn on. So our combine is full again. So this may not work out as well as I had hoped. Actually, what we're gonna do is get rid of this grain cart. It's because of the auto unloading function that it's doing that, which is a pain. So what we're going to do is we're going to rent the 1050 for a day. And we're going to go pick that up and then set course play up with that, because I know that grain cart works on course play because I've used it multiple times. Actually, that used to be my only grain cart that I'd use once it came out. And then the 1300 came out and I started using that. But that's more of a grain cart for when you're running grain cart yourself. That's not a grain cart for course play. I swear that there's a way that you can set that up to run, but well, now our cab light's on. But we'll turn it off now that we're not running grain cart. And we'll just turn on our front lights only. Snap a quick screenshot of that there. Alright, now we'll just pop over here and record a course quick. Up there, and we'll just pull ahead over here. That, and then go overloader, go drive the course. Hop over to our combine and make sure that he's got the driver requested. With that at fill level, and then we'll go back to this guy and set him up. And this, oh, where is it? Oh, it is right. Start at, we want that to be at 70 and drive on at 100. Oh man. Okay, so let's just see and make sure that this guy's going to run his course. Come on, there it goes. So field one, grain cart. So yeah, course play is going to drive over the crop. Nothing we can do about that. Kind of sucks. It's one of the worst things about course play, but it can't be helped. So I think actually what we'll do, once we finish this field, where's the baling at? I will rent this Heston baler, the round baler, and I will rent probably a 4430, and then we can bale all of this straw behind the combine. And what I'll do is I can just set the baler up on the combine course play course, and then it will just follow along behind the combine, and it'll pick up all the straw for us. That's what we'll do. And let's make sure that this guy's gonna automatically unload, otherwise we'll be in trouble. Please don't get in traffic. And you're going to. Oh, I hate that. Okay, so let's just back him up a little bit and get him. Oh, man, chills. You're not in traffic, you moron. We actually want him to be out further. 8 meters should do it. Man, this combine's not gonna auto unload. That's gonna suck. That's a nice feature, but it's a pain with courseplay. Okay, so we need to hop back in this guy and change his offset because he needs to be a whole lot farther away from the combine. Wow, really? Oh, gee. Should do it. I think we'll go to 9.7. Perfect. I was just gonna take a screenshot. Darn. See, let's tell this guy to drive now. And we're gonna run back to the yard and we are gonna get this auger set up. We need to open the hopper on this bin. I need to remember what key it is. That's 7. Cool. So let's get this guy set up now. As you can see, I have my tool camera running. Power line is going to be a pain. So what we're going to do is we're going to back... Okay, I need to get out of that view for now. We're going to back this guy up. This tractor backs up very, very slow, which sucks, but... It's a very, very awesome tractor otherwise. Alright, so we'll drive over this way, and then we'll back up to the bin here. We need to lift up our auger. Now we can switch on over to this camera and see what we need to do here. Alright, if we bring it straight back, oh, we need to turn a little bit. We need to pull ahead just a hair. Straighten this thing out a little bit. Alright, so now if we pull ahead a little bit and start dropping the auger down. Perfect. Right there ought to do it. So now, let's get that changed to that. Let's get this guy folded out so that way we can just check this out, get this all leveled out, and all that good stuff. Drop this bit down. We need to go this way with it. 6 level that way. Pop this up like that. A little bit more. Perfect. Now we'll swing this back in and wait for the truck to be full. And that's actually our timer right there. So we'll go a little while longer, just so that way you guys can see one of the full loads, because I don't want to just go through all this work for nothing. That'd suck for you guys. This thing's turning circle to be a whole lot smaller, because it's turning way too wide. There we go. Start unloading again. Let's actually bring this up and just hide all that, and then we can get a good screenshot here. There we go. So now we'll let the grain cart fill up, and hopefully we'll get enough that we can have a mostly full grain cart. We also need to adjust our reel here. Slide it forward all the way. There we go. Perfect. So I need to look and see how much our trailer holds. It holds 49,335. So we need about... Okay, so we need a little more. We'll have to request our driver again here in a moment. So we should turn any moment here. There we go. Now we're going to have a goofed up corner here because of course play, but oh well. So once our driver goes off, off duty, we'll say. There we go. Now we'll request him again. So we need about another... Well, once it empties the combine, it'll be able to fill the truck up. And then we'll auger our first load of grain into the bins, and then I'll go ahead and end the video. Because I don't want to have to have you guys watch all of this setup just to miss unloading the first load of grain, because that would suck for you guys, and I don't want to have to do that, because that would suck. That would just suck. So hopefully this guy empties out before it hits up here, hits its turn again. There we go. Let's tell this guy to drive now, so that way he fills up our truck. This is more than enough to fill up the truck, which is good. So we'll hop over here, get prepared to take a screenshot once the grain cart comes up here. There we go. We're waiting on you, grain cart. Let's go. Alright, cool. He's pulling up, so let's get a screenshot now. Alright, so like I said, this should fill our truck up. So let's see, we're just on the edge of the grass, and we're just a little ways from that driveway there. Alright, so this is going to fill us up. Then we can go ahead and truck on over to the farm. So tarp our trailer here. we are rolling out to the farm. Alright. So this trailer is a little bit heavy for this truck, but we'll make it. Actually, just this morning I was screwing around with this truck on Westbridge, testing out some different grain bins to see what they were like. And they were okay, but I couldn't get the dang things to empty for the life of me. So, why is he slipping? He's got to be hitting something. Whoa, we just about hit that pole. Yep, he's in a tree. Wow. Gotta love course playing its goof-ups. I think I should go and take out this farmyard here and just make it grass. Or, like, I'll just leave it and then go back with, like, a plow and plow it up and plant grass manually, because if I do it in Giant's Editor, what'll happen is it will want, I'll have to restart the save game and copy everything over to a new save game, which I could probably, I guess, and just, I might just do that. And, yep, he's gonna be stupid again. Wow. Just, wow. Gotta love when Courseplay is enjoying screwing up your day. There we go, back to our truck. Let's get this dang load hauled over to the farm and augered into the bin. Yeah, it looks like we might get some rain. Which I guess wouldn't necessarily be a bad thing. It would hold off harvest a little. Which that wouldn't be all that good. I need to look. How much does this bin hold? 250,000. Okay. So that'll hold roughly... Oh man, this truck is hard to slow down with a full load. It'll hold roughly five loads, five or six. About six loads. Because this is a little under 50,000, so if it were 50,000, we'd be able to haul five loads into the grain bin. And it would be full. But it is not 50,000 capacity, so that will not work, unfortunately. What we're going to have to do is we're going to have to just back up to the auger. I know it's not the most efficient way of doing it. Normally you would have it set up so that way you can just pull right up to it, but unfortunately our grain complex here is not set up that way. Alright, so let's get this guy swung out. We need to pull our truck ahead a ways. Hopefully that didn't... Oh, and it did. Dang. Oops. Transform group. Oh, that just screwed up our auger. Yeah, I have that set way too low. The jump auger was set way too far down. My bad. Now if I can line this dang thing up again, be nice. There we go. Alright. So let's hop back into our truck. Let's, we need to turn this guy on first. And then it is on. There, we can unload now. So let's get all that stuff shut off so that we can grab a screenshot again. There we go. So this here will, our inspector mod will allow us to see how full the grain bin is. We can also just hop inside here and see our fill plane going. So we won't worry about doing that a whole lot. See, the only bad thing about this trailer is it has two particle systems, so can't really get it to the right positioning. It'd be cool if you could script the trailers to unload each section individually, but I know, I think there was a trailer set up like that, but you know, you hit unload once the front section would drop, and then the front or rear section would drop. You know, it would only drop one section at a time, but, and the fill plane would go one section at a time too, which was cool, but let me pull ahead again just a little bit more. There we go. So I don't know if this, like, if the tractor's sliding or what the deal is. Or if the auger's sliding, maybe. Let's. Okay. So let's fold this guy back in. Perfect. Alright, guys. And we're going to end the video there. Next episode, we'll still be hard at the wheat, I'm sure. It wouldn't surprise me if we were. So yeah, I'm gonna keep rolling on with the harvest here for a little while I wait for my dad to come get me. Cause like I said, I'm going to the farm. And you guys have hopefully already seen farming footage. But if not, sorry. either I didn't get a chance to do it, or else maybe I just haven't uploaded it as of yet. That's going to do it all for this video, guys. If you enjoyed the video, smack that thumbs up button. And if you're new to the channel, make sure that you subscribe. And make sure that you turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. My video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central Time. And Saturdays at noon. Make sure you check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.